In this video, I'm going to tell you how to make money with YouTube in less than 30 days. Or should we change the title? Actually, you know what? How to start a successful YouTube channel in less than 30 days and find some success on the internet. Good titles, both of them. Let's get started. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Abhi Arya, father of two girls, six dogs, husband to a superwoman, a streetcar racer turned hotelier, now social media marketer and founder of Internet Moguls. Here are a few things that you need to do when you set up your YouTube channel. If you are watching and you already have a YouTube channel, well done. If you're watching and you don't have a YouTube channel, that's fine. Because after this video, you will have a bulb on moment and you will say, wow, I wish I knew this earlier, but now you know it, and you'll keep on scribbling notes, trying to understand what is happening, this. You'll put on your camera and you'll say, hey guys, my name is Abhi Arya, father of two girls. You will give your hero introduction as well. So I'm going to tell you how this works. Number one, decide the name of your channel. My channel is Ask Abhi Arya. Why? Because I want to encourage people to say that this is more of a Q&A platform. And I'll tell you why I keep it that way. Because the Q&A platform allows me to be slightly lazy. Because when people ask content, I've seen that all experts in any field, you could be a hairdresser, you could be a makeup artist, you could be a realtor, you could be a MLM marketer, you could be a digital marketer, you could be anybody. When people ask you questions regarding your passion and your work, you light up. I've seen you guys, you light up. And that makes for amazing content. When I see somebody lit up and answering a question, I'm like, where's the camera? Why is somebody not recording this? So when people ask questions to us about our passion, we light up. So why not have most of that content becoming a part of your channel? Number one. Number two, when you have an ask show, you get to answer people's questions, and there are hundreds of other people whose questions are answered by the way that you're answering one person's question. So that becomes your content machine forever. In your email, somebody said, Abhi, I want an answer. Here, go to this video, here's the link. On your Facebook group, somebody asked for an answer, you should have a link to every video. So when you have Ask series, then you have lots of questions and lots of answers, and you can have the top 100 answers copied and pasted. This is for real estate, this is for this, this is how I put my playlist. I put my playlist on Ask Abhi Arya real estate questions, Ask Abhi Arya travel agency questions, Ask Abhi Arya hospitality questions. So people can go and say, okay, this is what Ask Abhi is saying for digital marketing on hospitality, digital marketing on real estate. So that is why I'm very fond of the Ask format. Now you could be somebody who says, Abhi, I like to talk about my life and I like to document and I like to play around with things and color myself and do all those kinds of things, and you know, you like that, and I like to play with crazy stuff, and I like to, you know, just think aloud and maybe chew on time. I'm crazy and I want people to see my crazy life. That's absolutely fine. A lot of video game people are crazy and their crazy lives are blowing up on the internet. You do you. That's fine. That's more of a vlogging platform where your life is being documented by a camera, and in between you're talking about stuff. That's also fine. A lot of bloggers are able to monetize their podcasts with doing lots of different stuff. The third thing is, a lot of people say, Abhi, should I start with my name or my company name? I like to say one thing in Hindi, log logo ke saath kaam karna chahte hain, logo ke saath nahin. People want to work with a person and not the logo of the company. So don't hide behind the logo. Talk about yourself. Make it the Ask Abhi Arya show. Make it the Abhi Arya show. Make it Avi's magic. Make it Avi and his six dogs. Make it Avi and his two daughters. Make it my beautiful daughters and me and daddy and daughter. Make it personal. Make it something which people are like, wow, the six dogs that I rescued, who in turn rescued me, a TV show, YouTube show series. How my wife pulled me out of depression series. I mean, that's not what happened to me, but I mean, obviously my life is awesome, but I'm just telling you the series. It could be anything. Make it more personable. So that's the name and the reason behind the ask and everything, and how to structure your playlist. Great. We've done point number one. Now, it's very important to see the analytics. What kind of content should I create, Abhi? Great. Don't ask me. The best part about the internet is everything is on the internet. Go to Google Keyword Planner. Write it down. Google Keyword Planner. Go to Google Trends, go to Answer the Public, and go to SpyFu. Go to these four sites. When you go to SpyFu, you can actually type the competition, your own competition, and type their website, click enter. And SpyFu will give you the Facebook ads they're using, the videos they have, the social media ads, and you'll be like, oh my God, these guys have got some crazy ideas. Maybe I can do something similar. SpyFu will help you with that. Then I go to Google Trends and I see digital marketing news, digital marketing in India, digital marketing jobs. I'll put something around my industry and I'll click enter and I'll see my keywords and related keywords and where are they originating from. So if I go to Google Trends and it's US on top, it'll show me what people are... Is it happening? Are people searching for Google Trends, Google digital marketing jobs in Minnesota? Are they looking for it in LA or are they looking for it in New York? So I know accordingly where. So if I'm making a video, then I'll say, let me focus some videos on New York and say, hi guys from New York and all of that. So I know what to say and which part of which country, where the searches are coming from. Third is Google Keyword Planner. I like that tool as well. But for specifically for YouTube, I've got this one tool called TubeBuddy, right? Some of these guys are awesome. I met Rob and all of these awesome guys from TubeBuddy. It gives you very good analytics on what people are searching for in related channels. And eventually when you, you start using TubeBuddy, it gives you information about your data as well. I truly believe you should invest. These are not tools where you spend money, you invest money because it gives you data back about yourself and your channel. It's really good because then your success is much faster. So use TubeBuddy. So that's how you find your content. So then what I do is I write down 5 pieces of content that people are asking for. And one more thing I wanted to tell you was I also email my database or put it on Facebook. And if you have no followers, that's okay. Just tell people, I'm going to give you a free marker, free pen, free PDF, free guide, free comic book, whatever you want. If you can answer these 5 questions, I'm a digital marketer. What are the top 5 digital marketing questions I can answer for you on my new YouTube channel, which you don't find anywhere? People will say, can you tell me how to start a YouTube channel? Can you teach me how to start a YouTube channel for free? Can you tell me how to get my first 100 subscribers? Can you tell me the difference between YouTube and TikTok? Once you get all of this data, you know your first 5 topics and you start with that because there's already information available. So the first part was I told you how to name your channel, what's the strategy behind starting a channel. Then I told you what are the topics and how to get it from YouTube, TubeBuddy, Google Planner, all of that, and maybe ask the audience. And if you have no money, just put a poll, give a comic book, something for free that has value to your audience and get answers from them. Now, how frequently should I do a YouTube show? I want to do a YouTube show every day for the last so many years, but I'll be very honest to you, I've not been able to do it. So therefore, promise yourself something and stick to it. Like, I love Robin Sharma and I love his book, The 5 AM Club. If you see here, just to prove to you guys, I've got as many more books of Robin Sharma lying over there. I've got like hundreds of books. I love this guy. And look at the book, The 5 AM Club. I love him and I give these books out every day. I get him in the contest. Every day I do a webinar and every day I give out a book. Because I'm on a mission to do 365 webinars this year. But I don't follow the 5 a.m. system. So, but I follow it once a week. Once a week, I get up at 5 a.m. and I've got a club of few people and we meet once a week at 5 a.m. So that's my way of doing the 5 a.m. club. If you want to be a YouTuber, doesn't mean you need to do it every day. Or if you woke up and said, oh my God, I finally realized how important YouTube is. Now I need to make up for lost time. Don't make up for lost time by doing it every day. Choose one day or twice a week. Create your content, write down all of this thing, have a structured sheet together, and then start creating your video. So your frequency starts like that, and then you can do every day or whatever. Idea is to give answers to people's questions. People are burning, so they need that information. But now let me answer that question for you. I know that's in your mind, but everybody's given the information. What's new that I'm giving? Boss, you are the most unique human being on the planet. Some people will resonate with your energy. You owe it to yourself to put yourself out there for others. And when you get your first 100 subscribers, you say, hey, they had 30 other places to go to. Why didn't they come to me? And what were they doing when I was not putting on videos? A complete perspective shift happens when you realize you're not doing it for yourself, you're doing it for other people. Okay, then is to brand your show. Oh, I love it. I use StreamYard sometimes, the software called StreamYard, and I interview people for the Ask Aviarya show, and I upload StreamYard, the entire show directly. It gives me a whole banner, cover, it looks like a proper TV show. Half the screen is mine, half is somebody else, just take, come and go. So I like that kind of a banner image. You can design it, you can have skins on your YouTube channel. I like this way of doing it. Brand it, definitely brand it. And I like one more thing. I like to say, Ask Aviarya launching every Thursday, 8 p.m. Don't miss it. So that people in their minds remember when your show is dropping. That's how you brand it, because it's regular. Now we're coming to have an intro and an outro. Guys, for all of you people who've been following me, my hero introduction. My name is Avi Arya, father of two girls, six dogs, husband to a superwoman, streetcar racer turned hotelier, now social media marketer and founder of the Micro Video Mastery System, a system of 33 micro videos that any entrepreneur can use to take their personal brand and improve and increase their influence and income on the internet, even if they've never ever made a video in their lives, right? So that kind of stuff happens. Put that intro in the beginning and put that outro outside. At the end. And then in the middle, you give the meat of the matter. How do you plan the meat of the matter? Very simple. Always think of three ways of answering one question. Three answers to one question. How do you start your YouTube channel and get 100 people, 100 this thing? Okay, today I'm going to tell you about how to brand your channel, how to find the right audience, and eventually how to get traffic to that audience. Finished. And before, hi, my name is Avi Arya, father of two girls, six dogs. Intro, three things in the meat of the matter. And at the end, you put your outro. That's it. Finished. Keep it as simple as possible. How long should a video be? Right now I'm at 12 minutes. Maybe I'll finish at 16, 17. Doesn't matter. If your message is going out there, you know when you hit it. Sometimes it could be 5 minutes, sometimes it could be half an hour, depending on what you're teaching them. Have them at least give three step answer to the question that they're searching. Because remember, YouTube is a search engine. People are asking for questions. Remember, I love a how-to for my topic, how to do this, how to do that. So your how-to will always help, okay? And your answer also, keep it in mind that you are answering a how-to question. One more thing that you can initial, very important. After the hero introduction, in today's video, I'm going to teach you how to make money with YouTube, even if you've never ever shot a video before. So start with that. So people are like, okay, because the first few seconds, if they don't like it, they're like, this is not the video. Hi, my name is Avi Arya, father of two girls, six dogs, husband to a superwoman, streetcar racer turned hotelier, now social media marketer, founder of Internet Moguls. In this video, you're going to learn how to start your YouTube channel and find success in the first 30 days. And if you watch till the very end, I am going to give you this book called Bedtime Stories by Tomorrow's Entrepreneurs that me and my daughters wrote. And it's got how they started as a 14-year-old kids, how they started their YouTube channel. Now, some people could say this is very long, so maybe this is a different format. You have to keep testing. Instead of the hero introduction coming first, maybe we can say, in this video, you're going to learn how in the first 30 days, you can have your 30 videos go out and find your YouTube success. My name is Avi Arya, father of two girls, six dogs, husband to a superwoman, streetcar racer. Test both and see if people are leaving. Testing is data, and that's how the internet works, right? And then in the middle, I like one more formula. Don't forget that. Always tell a story. Always have a repertoire of stories. We all know that, especially in India. I mean, around the world as well. The mothers, fathers, grandfathers, everybody's given a story. My dad always says in Hindi, kaam karne ke 100 bahane, na karne ke 100 bahane. And then I tell people how my dad told me that story. There was this time when I reached the office and because we were working in my dad's hotel and I did a 12-hour shift and I was very tired and he said, just get a nap. I got a nap for an hour and then there was another check-in. Some other foreigners came in. There was check-in happening, group check-in. And I said, how do I do another shift? To my dad said, kaam karne ke 100 bahane, na karne ke 100 bahane. Means that you find 100 reasons to do something, 100 not to. That sort of told me, you know, what do I want to do right now? So I pushed my body. I was 24 years old. I pushed my body and I checked them. And I worked for another 6-7 hours. So this can be applied in any of this thing. So ladies and gentlemen, I remember what my dad, one thing that he said changed my life. So I bring in stories. So you can bring in a story from, or if you don't remember, I think it's a good idea to have a repertoire of story. But otherwise, read a story every time. Hi guys. This is what I wanted to tell you. And have a marked story. Have it already marked. Okay. So I have a story for you guys. There was these two girls, Raya and Aviana, and their father. And Raya was 10 and Aviana was 8. And we combined their names together and made it Raviana. And their passion was around chocolate. So we founded a fictitious chocolate factory called Raviana Chocolates. And we started telling stories about everyday escapades of Raya and Aviana going to school, to the chocolate factory as entrepreneurs. And then they hired a mentor called Avi, who they used to meet every Thursday. And this became a story to teach kids to become entrepreneurs. And one day we thought we'd give it a spin and we made it Bedtime Stories for Tomorrow's Entrepreneurs. Anyway, so this was a side story, ladies and gentlemen. Coming back to how to make your YouTube video. So you see what I'm doing? You can tell a story in between and people love a story format. So ladies and gentlemen, that is it from me for now. There are many other videos that I'm going to be making in the series of how to start and grow your YouTube channel for success. Don't overthink it. I'm going to sum it up. Start with your hero introduction. give the meat of the matter, three parts in the meat of the matter, give your outro, make sure that you've written it down so you know what you're going to be talking about. Start with saying, in this video, you're going to learn this, 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 and then give your hero introduction and then try the vice versa as well. In the end, sum it up. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. In this video, you learned these three things and you can have captions coming down. And at the end, make sure that you put a link to say, if you like this and if you want to work with me, click on the link below and you can find a calendar link where you can book a 20-minute call with me if you want help to start your YouTube channel or you want to work in my Micro Video Mastery program or whatever you want. So then people click on the link, like I'm asking you people, click on the link. They'll book a calendar call with you. You'll get their email address and then you can start a funnel series of giving them videos and testimonials and emails and all of that. So before the final call, they know more about you than they knew. So then you can get online consulting gigs as a reason for one video. That's why I say the MVM system is you use your videos to go out there and do sales for you and you can sleep. And when you get up, they'll say video number 7 on YouTube got you one client. And here is the appointment. Go ahead and talk because the appointment is automatically scheduled on Calendly and your 20-minute call is tomorrow morning at 12:30. How did that call happen? Because you invested time to make a proper YouTube video using the MVM system. Interesting? So ladies and gentlemen, videos work like crazy. They are your sales team, they help it. So to make your YouTube video, I hope this video was helpful. Thank you very much. Please don't forget to subscribe. Tell your friends, mother, father, husband, wife, grandmother, grandfather, neighbors, everybody to come in and subscribe here and drop in some love and use the comments to ask questions if you're not clear. I'm not going to be like other YouTubers. I'm going to make sure. I shouldn't say that. Sorry. I take that back. I'm not going to be what I was earlier on. I'm going to be a good YouTuber. And I'm going to try to answer as many questions as possible. Otherwise, fix a call with me or my team. Or get into the program. I've got a link to a free program here as well. That allows you to get into my funnel. So that eventually you get into my senior, my course. Or my Facebook group. Somewhere I'm doing some kind of marketing to invite you into my world. I hope that's okay and that's exactly what I'm teaching you. End of the video. Why do I do this at the end of every video? Stay tuned. You'll know in the next video. Watch it now.